Look what the series. Vayomer Hashem el Avraham, lech lecha me'artecha. So who are we going to bring in? Avraham Avinu is going to save the world. How's Avraham Avinu going to save the world? So it's not like a comic. I'm not telling you like a superhero story. Avraham Avinu comes and he saves the world. Comes the Or HaChaim and says a very big question. Kadosh Baruch Hu says to Avraham Avinu, lech lecha me'artecha u'mimoladatecha. Says the Or HaChaim HaKadosh, he asks a question. Over here we see that HaKadosh Baruch Hu is just talking to Avram. Did he reveal himself yet to Avram? Did HaKadosh Baruch Hu reveal himself yet to Avram? When did HaKadosh Baruch Hu reveal himself to Avram? Vayera elav Hashem belone mamre. Yeah, until Vayera elav Hashem. Okay, let's take a few minutes to... Until Vayera elav Hashem belone mamre, HaKadosh Baruch Hu doesn't reveal himself to Avram Avinu. Over here, it's just a talking, it's just a conversation. Lech lecha me'artecha u'mimoladatecha. So, the question of the Or HaChaim is, why is HaKadosh Baruch Hu first talking to Avraham without revealing himself to him? You following the question? So, there's a conversation, there's a commandment, and there's no revelation. Vayomer Hashem el Avraham lech lecha. Now we said that the idea of Noach was, because we're tying in last week's parasha into this week's parasha, that the idea of Noach was, the Dor HaMabul, was a generation of people who gave up. They gave up what was right and wrong. Nobody wanted to fight anymore about what was right and wrong. Even Noach himself, to some extent, again, we can't talk about tzaddikim because the Torah calls Noach a tzaddik, but to some extent, even Noach gave up. And that's why the Mefarshim says that if Noach lived in the generation of Avraham, he wouldn't have been such a great tzaddik. Because we saw the one thing by Avraham, he never gave up. Avraham never gave up. Comes the Or HaChaim and says like this.
I would say that Noach would learn from Avraham and be
a... How can Noach learn from Avraham? Avraham was after Noach.
No, I'm saying if he was in his generation, he would have been a huge tzaddik.
Okay, so that's the other pshat of the Chachamim. The other pshat of the Chachamim is that if Noach lived in the generation of Avraham, he would have been a greater tzaddik. But listen to the Or HaChaim HaKadosh, yeah? He says that Avraham Avinu, look what he says, Oliot she'alav ha'shalom nishtadel ba'karat boro, ma she'lo asa adam zulato ven 5 shanim mikir boro me'atzmo b'itchakmuto. When did Avraham Avinu come to Noach HaKadosh Baruch Hu at 5 years old? How did he come to know HaKadosh Baruch Hu? How did Avraham come to know Hashem? He used his head.
He searched for him.
He searched. He was a seeker. Avraham Avinu was a seeker. He seeked. You know what it means to seek? Yeah? It means to go on Google and search. Avraham Avinu was the Google of the world. He searched. He went out to the world and he started to search. He said, "The camp. Where did Avraham Avinu? His father was the biggest priest of idolatry in the world." Everybody knows the famous Midrash, right? Right, the statues. They had big statues, small statues in the house. All of a sudden, Avraham Avinu's father Terach comes into the house, and he sees the big statue broken. He sees the small statue broken. Goes, "What happened?" Avraham Avinu said, "Oh, they got in a fight and they broke it." He goes, "What do you mean they got in a fight? They're statues." Goes, "What do you mean they're statues? You believe in them?" That's what Avraham Avinu says to Terach. "What do you mean they're statues? You believe in them? They broke each other." So Avraham Avinu never gave up. But it says, the Or HaChaim says, why did HaKadosh Baruch Hu not reveal himself to Avraham Avinu? So Avraham Avinu at the age of 5 starts to search. Starts to go, he starts to see the sun. Then the sun comes down and goes up. He goes, "The sun can't be God." Everybody knows the Midrash. Then the moon, he goes, "The moon's at night, can't be God." He sees a castle that's burning. And he says, "Oh, there has to be an owner to this castle." Says the Or HaChaim, "Lazeh lo tzrach li galot elav el amar elav dibotav," because HaKadosh Baruch Hu didn't need to reveal himself to Avraham Avinu. Avraham Avinu was already at such a level that he knew God. And since he knew God, he didn't even need to reveal himself to God. God didn't even need to reveal himself to him. It was enough to tell him, Lech lecha me'artzecha. At that point, he wasn't even revealed. He doesn't even know God. Can you imagine? You're the only person in the world that believes in a creator. That creator doesn't even reveal himself to you. All he's doing is talking to you.
Well, if he's talking, that's revealing, technically, no?
So what? Maybe you hear voices.
I was going to say that, actually.
Maybe you're hearing voices.
But it's revealing.
All he's doing... No, it's not. He didn't. It says, Vayralav Hashem b'elonim amret. He didn't reveal himself to him yet. And Avraham... Yeah? What do you mean? No, that's a good point. But he was in... As a public figure, he was the only one. He was the only one that Yeshiva, Shem, Vever, they were there doing their stuff, but they didn't go out. Avraham Avinu went out to the world. That's where it says, Hav Amon Goyim. Avraham Avinu had Gerim, he brought in Gerim. But comes the Or HaChaim and says like this. He says that since Avraham Avinu, he says, או אפשר כי להיות האדם ראשון בקדושה אשר בעשרה דורות שגמול, לא היה אדם שהכיר אלא אותו ודיבר איתו עליהם, לזה הנהג השם יום בבשר הצל. Nobody else, that even though you had the yeshiva of Shem ever, nobody else knew Hashem like Avraham Avinu. And he says like this, the Midrash Rabbah says as follows. He says, by the way, that you should know, the only reason that Moshe Rabbeinu, when HaKadosh Baruch Hu revealed himself in the Sneh to Moshe Rabbeinu in the burning bush, the only reason that Moshe Rabbeinu was able even to believe was because of Avraham Avinu. Avraham Avinu is Shrish Emuna. We say, Ma'aseh Avot Siman Labanim. It's the, whatever happens to our forefathers, whatever happens to Avraham, Yitzchak, V'Yaakov, it really has to happen to every single one of us. And the only way that we're able to endure those challenges in life is because Avraham Avinu was the foundation. Because Avraham Avinu, it says, Avraham Avinu believed in Hashem v'techashev lo l'tzedakah. He believed in God and was for him like tzedakah. Because who else is going to teach you about God? He enrooted in each and every single one of you the ability to believe in HaKadosh Baruch Hu. So when the Torah tells you these stories, these are not just stories. These are ideas that are telling you, Avraham Avinu believed, you believed. It's inherent in a Jew when he comes down to the world that he believes in HaKadosh Baruch Hu, and you cannot deny that belief. Because Avraham Avinu believed, you're a believer also. Because Avraham Avinu seeked, you're also a seeker. It's inside of you. That you didn't bring it out yet, or that's a different story. But it's inside of you. It's embedded in you. Whatever Avraham went through, he went through 10 trials, you're also going to go through 10 trials. Avraham Avinu passed those 10 trials, you can also pass those 10 trials. And because Avraham Avinu passed those 10 trials, you have the ability to pass those 10 trials. Foundation of Klal Yisrael, Avraham Avinu. Why? We'll see. Vayomer Hashem el Avraham, lech lecha mi'artzecha, Rabbi Yitzchak patach, comes Rabbi Yitzchak and says, there's a pasuk in Tehillim, in Perek, 45 Mem Hey, says Shimi Baturi Vati Oznech Veshichi Amech Ubet Avich. Listen, the daughter, tilt your ears, forget your nation and the house of your forefathers. Amar Rabbi Yitzchak Mashal Echad Shaya Over Mimakom LeMakom VeRa Bira Echad Doleket. It's an analogy of a person that was going from one place to another place. He saw a bira, he saw a castle, he saw a building, whatever you want to call it. He saw it on fire. Amar tomar shabira zot belo manig. Maybe you're going to say that this castle has no leader, has no owner. What happened, says the Midrash? Itzitz alav ba'al habira. The owner of the castle, the owner of the bira, peeked out. Amar lo ani ba'al habira. I'm the owner. Kach lefi shayav avinu Avraham omer tomar sha'olam belo manig. Avraham avinu came. How can this world exist without a creator? How can it be? Itzitz alav HaKadosh Baruch Hu v'amar lo ani ba'al ha'olam. You seek me? I'll talk to you. And that's it. That's a message to every Jew. You seek HaKadosh Baruch Hu, he's going to show you. You really want to see HaKadosh Baruch Hu, you're going to see him. You hear what the Midrash Rabbah says? A person says, I want to see a Kadosh Baruch Hu, I want a Kadosh Baruch Hu to reveal himself, he can reveal himself to you. You'll see him in the world. In the same way that a Kadosh Baruch Hu revealed himself to Avraham Avinu, because the Torah is a Torah Chaim, remember what we say, the Torah is a living Torah, it's talking to you right now. A Kadosh Baruch Hu is going to reveal himself to you also. What does that mean? You'll see him in your life. You'll see a Kadosh Baruch Hu, Karov Hashem, Lechol Karav, Lechol Asher Karu Ve'emet. Hashem is close to all those, but you have to seek him full-heartedly. What does it mean that you have to seek him full-heartedly? You can either be like Avraham Avinu, or you can be like Haran. What's Haran? Comes Avraham Avinu, he's going to be tested. Yeah, who's he going to be tested by? Nimrod. Who's he going to be tested by? Nimrod. Nimrod comes to Avraham Avinu, or you're a believer, you believe in the Kadosh Baruch Hu, no problem, I'm going to put you in the fire. Avraham Avinu says, okay, you want to put me in the fire? Put me in the fire. After Avraham Avinu gets put in the fire, they ask his brother Haran, they go, Haran, which side are you on? On Avraham Avinu's side or on our side? What does he say?
Abraham.
Obviously. You saw a miracle. Now whose side are you going to be on? What happens to Aran?
He dies.
Why does he die? Why did the Kadosh Baruch Hu perform a miracle for him? He didn't pass the test.
No, he didn't believe.
You only believe.
He didn't pass the test. Avraham Avinu passed the test. Why do you say every morning, you say three times a day in your tefillot, Elokei Avraham? How come Avraham Avinu was zoche to this idea of Elokei Avraham? Everybody knows the famous Midrash, right? David HaMelech says, it says Elokei Avraham, Elokei Yitzchak, Elokei Yaakov. How come it doesn't say Elokei David? What does the Kadosh Baruch Hu answer him? They were tested, you weren't. Avraham Avinu is constantly being tested. You know why you came to this world? What's your purpose of coming into this world?
To be tested.
Huh?
To be tested.
Chazak. That's why a person comes into this world. A person comes into this world to constantly be tested. You're going to be tested and you have to accept those tests. Avraham Avinu was ready. Avraham Avinu was tested with everything. And he was ready to accept those tests. A person comes to this world and he's going to be tested. That's why HaKadosh Baruch says, "And Vitav HaMelech Yifrach Kodonach, Vitav HaMelech Yifrach Lefatok Leafotach Ba'olam." HaKadosh Baruch Hu is going to make beautify Avraham. Listen to this Midrash. It says like this. Says when HaKadosh Baruch Hu Ele Todot Shemayim Va'aretz Bi'Ibraham. What does the Mefarshim says? Don't read Al Tikra Bi'Ibraham Ela Be'Avraham. You know what it says about that Midrash? Who did HaKadosh Baruch Hu see when he was creating the world?
Avraham.
HaKadosh Baruch Hu, when he was created the world, he saw who? Max, who?
Avraham.
Why? He saw Avraham. Saw Avraham Avinu. And because of Avraham Avinu, he created the world. Listen to the Gemara. The Gemara says like this. The Gemara in Sanhedrin Lamed Chet says like this, yeah? That the Malachim had a conversation before HaKadosh Baruch Hu was creating the world. They said to him like this. Amar Rabbi Yehuda Amar Rav. Comes Rabbi Yehuda in the name of Rav and says, B'sha'a shebikesh HaKadosh Baruch Hu livot et ha'adam. At the time that HaKadosh Baruch Hu wanted to create man, Malachi Asheret Amar Lahem Retzonchem Na'aseh Adam Betzalmenu. He goes to the Malachim, he asks the Malachim, do you will that we should make a man in our image? Amar, what did they answer? Amu lefanav Ribono Sholam, Ma Ma'asav. What's he going to be like? This man that you want to create, what is he going to do? Amar Lahem Kach Vekach Ma'asav. Listen, some days he's going to be doing good, some days he's going to be doing bad, I don't know, you know, he's up in Adam, this guy. What did they answer? Amar Lahem, what Amul lefanav Ribono Shalom, my nosh ki tiskerenu, this frail man, what do you need him? What does the Kadosh Baruch Hu do to them? What does he do to them? Huh? David, what does he do to them?
I don't know, single out something else just now.
He burns them, yeah?
You think about pain kills
them. It says, Oshia, Oshit etz baktana benehem usafam. God extends his little fingers and he burns them. V'chen kachnia, also the second set of angels. Kachlishit comes the third set of angels. Amu lefanav ribono shel olam rishonim shamu lefanecha. The first angels that spoke to you, Ma'ilu, what are you asking us? Look, they told you their opinion, you didn't like it, you burnt them. What do you want us to answer now? Twice we saw angels being burnt. We're going to answer? What happened? They tell him, Kol alam kulo shelcha. Asek, whatever you want to do, the whole world is yours. Kevan shehigia lan shedor ha-mabul v'shedor ha-flaga, when the people of the generation of the flood and the people of Anshe Bavel and all these generations that sinned greatly in front of HaKadosh Baruch Hu, shemaaseh mekulkalim, their actions were corrupt. Amu lefanav, come the third set of angels and say, Ribono shel olam, lo yafe amu rishonim lefanecha, look at the actions of man. Look how bad they are. Man has perversed their ways. Didn't the first two set of angels say, God, what do you need this guy for? What do you need this brave man in the world? Look, he's constantly complaining. He's constantly doing evil. Amar lahem, ve'ad zikna nihu, ve'ad seva nizbo. What did the Kadosh Baruch Hu answer? Until old age, I am. Ve'ad seva anizbo. What do you mean, until old age? What kind of answer is that? They tell him, look at these two generations. So the first set of angels were right. Man is going to do bad deeds. What do you need him for? Comes the Kadosh Baruch Hu and says, Ve'at zikna niyu, ve'at seva nizbo. You understand this answer? What does that mean? I'm going to, ve'at zikna niyu. Until I'm old age, I am. He until hornets I will bear. What does that mean? What kind of answer is that?
Say
that again. Ve'ad zikna anihu. Until old I am. So what did we just say? When HaKadosh Baruch Hu created the world, who did he see in front of him?
Abraham.
We know that there's a midrash that says what? That Abraham and Yitzchak, they looked very much alike. And wherever they went, right? Wherever they went, people couldn't tell the difference between a father and son. So the Midrash says that Avram says to Kadosh Baruch Hu, look, we're walking together, nobody knows who is. There's no aging in the world. Nobody knows anything. Yitzchak looks like he's 30, Avram looks like he's 30. So Avram says to Avram, what does it say? Okay, you know what, we'll start with you. V'Avraham, Zaken Baba Yamim. What does the Kadosh Baruch Hu mean that I'm good? Wait for me, Ad Zikna. You'll see the reason I created the world. Even though you saw two generations that weren't doing good, Ad Zikna, there's going to come an old person called Avraham. V'Avraham, Zaken Ba Bayamim. This Ad Zikna, Kadosh Baruch Hu is hinting to the angels, wait, you'll see a person that the whole world was created because of him. Who's this person that the whole world was created because of him? Avraham Zaken Ba Bayamim. The second answer is, when HaKadosh Baruch Hu reveals himself to Am Yisrael, in Har Sinai it says that how is HaKadosh Baruch Hu, how does he reveal himself to them? How does HaKadosh Baruch Hu show himself to Am Yisrael at Har Sinai? Ke'ish zaken, like an old man. What's the pshat? Because obviously, barati yetzera, barati Torah tavlin. I created a yetzera and I created a Torah tavlin. So until Matan Torah, yeah, man can go all over. Comes Matan Torah, Kadosh Baruch Hu says, wait till I'm old. What does it mean, wait till I'm old? Two pshatim we said, two ideas. One is Avraham Avinu, one is the Torah. Because there are two reasons that are going to be created, that are going to let the world go. Avraham Avinu is one reason, the Torah, because the Torah says a person has a Yetzirah, he's something taking him to the evil. But the Torah is going to bring you back. But let's focus on this other pshat. The pshat is of Avraham Avinu. HaKadosh Baruch Hu looked at Avraham Avinu and he created the world. And because of Avraham Avinu, he tells the angels, the world is, it makes sense to create the world. And you see by Avraham Avinu, HaKadosh Baruch Hu calls him what? Avraham Ahuvi. It says that Avraham Avinu, we see, what does Avraham Avinu do? He goes all over the world. The reason HaKadosh Baruch Hu tells Avraham Avinu, Lech Lecha Me'artzecha Me'odcha Me'bet Avicha, Avraham Avinu, HaKadosh Baruch Hu says to Avraham Avinu, I see what you're doing. I see what you're doing. You're not staying in your tent. You're fighting. You're fighting people, everybody, the whole world around you is telling you there's no God. The whole world around is telling you, come on, leave it, it's not for you. Just do what you feel like it. Do what makes you happy. Hashem says, Avraham, I see you fighting. You have to leave. What does it mean you have to leave? The Midrash says it means, you know what it means? It means like you have a good smelling perfume. And with that good smelling perfume, you got to take it all around. So the good smelling perfume pours around to the world. And you're right that Avraham Avinu was creating, was showing the world about God. And Avraham Avinu was bringing goyim. And we know that the Midrash says that people, when they came to Avraham Avinu, he would let them eat. And when he let them eat, what did he do to them after? He made them say the Birkat HaMazon. But I want to tell you an idea. Why does Lech Lecha come after Parashat Noach? Why does the Kadosh Baruch Hu answer the angels? You're right, Dora Mabul, disaster. Dora Aflaga, disaster. And you know that the world was a disaster, why? Because HaKadosh Baruch Hu destroyed it. Comes Avraham Avinu and what happens? The world is recreated. HaKadosh Baruch Hu recreates the world again. All for who?
Max.
Avraham Avinu. He recreates the world again for this person called Avraham. This is the beginning of it all. The beginning of Am Yisrael is really by Avraham Avinu. Everything starts by this person, Avraham. So what is it that HaKadosh Baruch Hu wants you to learn from Avraham Avinu? We already said that the Nisyonot that Avraham Avinu went through, you're going to go through. So Avraham Avinu, what was he?
Fight.
He was a fighter. HaKadosh Baruch Hu tells Am Yisrael, you could be the biggest tzaddik, but if you're going to stay in your tent, I'm not looking for that. I'm looking for a nation that are seekers. I'm looking for a nation that are fighters. I'm looking, how do you know that mitamido shel Avraham Avinu bashanim gomel chesedim? A person has to be gomel chesed. What does it mean that you have to be gomel chesed? Don't leave the Torah for you. Go out there and spread the Torah to everybody else. We know that Mashiach, HaKadosh Baruch Hu, is not going to give up on any Jew. You have to live in today's world. You have to be Avraham Avinu. You have to get up and you have to tell people what's right and what's wrong. If the world is going in a way that's wrong, you have to get up and tell the world this is wrong. That's Avraham Avinu. The whole world is worshipping Avodah Zarah. We're going to throw you in the fire. No problem, I'm willing to go. And Avraham Avinu embedded that idea in every single one of us. Avraham Avinu gave us the power to be fighters. Avraham Avinu gave us the power to be seekers. Think about this. We said this many times. The biggest test of Avraham Avinu, he went. He spread HaKadosh Baruch Hu in the world. Then when it comes to sacrifice his only child, and really without Yitzchak Avinu, you have no continuation for the world. It says, Vayashkem Avraham Baboker. Avraham Avinu says, logic, not logic. The world is against me. The world's not against me. I'm getting up and doing what's right. When it comes to save Lot, Avraham goes and saves Lot. By Zdom Vamora. What do you care about Zdom Vamora? What do you care about these people? It's a city that they're all sinners. No, Avraham says, I'm here to save the world. He prayed for them. He prayed for the world. When it was about to get rich, the parson says, I'm not going to take a filu misroch now. Shelo tagid adni shavti to Avraham. I don't need your wealth. That's the power of Emunah. Avraham Avinu goes against wealth. Avraham Avinu, Hashem takes him down to Mitzrayim. They're going to take away his wife. No problem. I still have Emunah in HaKadosh Baruch Hu. That's the power of Avraham Avinu. That's why that's the foundation of the Jewish people. Because the Arizal says, and we said this many times, that when the time's come for Mashiach, where is HaKadosh Baruch Hu going to test every Jew? Where is he going to test us?
Emunah.
V'anochi aster aster panai. You know what the biggest fear is? when you live a life where you don't see a Kadosh Baruch Hu. That's the biggest fear. That's the generation that we're living in today. A world where a Kadosh Baruch Hu seems like the world is functioning on its own. Everybody's free to do whatever they want. V'anochi asteh, that's the biggest fear that there is. But a person has to battle. That's Avraham Avinu. Everything goes back to the beginning. Kegula rishona, gula achona. The challenge is emunah. That a person has to believe in a Kadosh Baruch Hu steadfast. Tzadik ba Chabakuk v'midan alechad. The Gemara says that Chabakuk came and he said there's one foundation for a Jew that you cannot leave. What's the foundation of a Jew that you cannot leave? Tzadik b'emunato yichyeh. What gives life to a person is emunah in a Kadosh Baruch Hu. And that's where you come into the second answer. That when the Malachim says to HaKadosh Baruch Hu, I'm going to destroy, what kind of world it is? HaKadosh Baruch Hu says, Va'ad Zikna. What's the second answer? Va'ad Zikna? Wait till the Torah comes into the world. When HaKadosh Baruch Hu revealed himself to Am Yisrael at Har Sinai, he revealed himself like an old man. What's the hint? You're right that emunah is everything. But without Torah, a person cannot have emunah. The only thing that can strengthen, we said this a few times, the Maharal says that when the giving of the Torah happened, the greatest connection to HaKadosh Baruch Hu now becomes what? Torah. You want to strengthen your emunah? You have to plug in something called Torah. Comes HaKadosh Baruch Hu and tells the angels, you know why I created man? Because there's going to be a time, Ve'ad Zikna, that I'm going to reveal myself as an old man in that place called Har Sinai, Matan Torah, where they're going to get the thing that's going to keep them going, the Torah. Because when a person's engaged in Limud the Torah, that gives them emunah. The reason that Avraham Avinu, it says that Avraham Avinu, how many prakim do we have in Masechet Avodah Zarah? Avraham Avinu had 400 prakim. Much more than we have. 400 prakim. It says that Avraham Avinu's, his klayot, became to him, they became his teachers. He was a walking Sefer Torah, Avraham Avinu.
Kidneys.
His kidneys advised, they became to him teachers. He was a walking Sefer Torah. That's where he got the power. You want to have emunah? You want to see clarity? You want to see a Kadosh Baruch Hu in today's world? You have to have Torah. That's bad zikna. You have to combine the power of emunah, which we got from Avraham Avinu, and the power of Har Sinai. When you have emunah, and the Torah is constantly being mechazek, it's constantly strengthening that emunah, you're constantly going to be seeing a Kadosh Baruch Hu. That's the foundation of Am Yisrael, Avraham Avinu, and the Torah. Said the Kadosh Baruch Hu, you know the two reasons I created the world? Ve'ad zikna, really two interpretations. Emunah and Torah. And the reason, and the way that a person strengthens his emunah, is only al yidei Torah. So that's the correction for Dor HaMabul. Dor HaMabul, they gave up. Right, wrong, doesn't matter. That's what we're doing today. You can't give up. There is no, you do what you want, I do what I want. You have to be Avraham Avinu. You have to be a fighter. You have to go out and tell the world there's a right and there's a wrong and there's a God. Yesh din v'yesh dayan. Of course, then you have to do like the way Avraham Avinu did it. Ba'ava. But you have to stand up for what's right. That's why Kadosh Baruch says, Shama ele todot shamayim v'aretz b'ivaram, I saw a person. Be'avraham, I saw an image, said the Kadosh Baruch Hu. And when I saw that image, I said, it makes sense to create the world. Why? Because he's never going to give up what's right and what's wrong. And Avraham Avinu embedded that in every single one of us, because he's the foundation of Am Yisrael. Av lamon goyim. And that's our lesson from this week. That a person has to strengthen his emunah. And he has to never give up. He has to be a fighter just like Avraham Avinu.